before the 2002 Women's Gold Cup began, the U.S. and Canada were set for a collision course. Here they meet in the 2002 Women's Gold Cup final, with both only assured spots at the World Cup in China. But bragging rights certainly on the line here. A couple months ago, the U.S. edged Canada under 19 championship, and the Canadians have not forgot it. The U.S. are looking to make it 2-for-2 over Canada regional championships. The U.S., Canada, Honduras. The Gold Cup final next. Welcome to the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. The United States taking on Canada for the 2002 Women's Gold Cup Championship. And let's listen in to the Canadian National Anthem. United States, and now the American National Anthem. The United States and Canada fighting it out once again for regional supremacy. Some say there's not much on the line, but I think there certainly is quite a bit at stake. Regional pride, certainly one of them. Let's take a look at the starting 11 for the United States. Rhianna Scurry in goal. We look at the starting 11. Milbritt's been outstanding throughout the entire tournament. Kate Sabrell in the back line, Foudy, Parlow, Lillian Fawcett, everyone has been outstanding. The U.S. yet to allow a goal in the tournament. The defense will be put to the task today against a Canadian side that's allowed one goal, but has scored 25 times in the tournament, feasting off weak opposition. Sinclair, the tournament's leading goal scorer, with 7. She was the leading goal scorer in the under 19 Women's World Cup just a couple months ago. And Charmaine Hooper, she has 6 goals, but 9 against the United States, the most ever for any one player versus the U.S. Ellen Hopkins alongside Tracy Milburn. Tracy, this was what we've been waiting for, U.S. and Canada. Your thoughts before the kickoff?
Well, I'm excited. Well, I know these players are excited to play each other. It's going to be a great game and a great battle for the whole 90 minutes, and I think both teams are ready, and they're not going to be happy with just making it here to the finals.
In some ways, the pressure is off. In some ways, it's on. As Canada looking to make that step, looking to beat the U.S. on home soil in a tournament. Evan Pellerud has beaten the U.S. before as coach of Norway back in the 95 edition of the World Cup. He's taking over this Canadian team. He was disappointed with their performance against Mexico, feeling like his team didn't respond very well to the pressure of the match. And if not for 2 own goals by Mexico, they would have played before this final championship match.
I don't think they responded too well either, coming into Mexico, and they only won 2-0 again with two own goals, and I think that they've got to be a lot more prepared today, and I think a lot of that pressure is off of them, obviously, and is on the United States today. So hopefully they'll come out a little looser and a little more relaxed and have a little more confidence today.
Will be interesting to see how open this match is. Both coaches have hinted that with the hard work already done qualifying for the World Cup, it could be a very open and attack-minded match. Of course, all that talk coming before the kickoff. Look at the Canadian bench. Diane Perez-James for Guyana is our referee. She's joined by Isabel Tovar of Mexico and Linda Bramble of TNT. 28 previous meetings between these two countries. The U.S. holds a big advantage. 23 wins, 3 draws, 2 losses all time. And we're on the way. The 2002 Women's Gold Cup Final. The 16th and final match of this tournament. The tournament began right here on October 27th. And nearly 3 weeks later, it comes to an end. Candace Chapman. Good ball floated in. The U.S. defense, which has been outstanding, to say the least. Here's Fowdy, the captain. Here's Kate Sobrero. Sydney Parlow. And those long limbs after it. Brianna Boyd clears it away. I mentioned the U.S. with a big advantage all the time, but only 4-2-2 in the last 8 matches. Since 2001, 2-2 in the last 5. Throwing for the U.S. That one hit the corner flag. Right in front of Randy Hermes. Tiffany Roberts. The throw in. Good tackle by Sobrero. Roberts floats it in. The rain not as heavy as we saw it in the first match, which will certainly aid both clubs. But now rain has stopped. The throw in didn't look quite right.
You're on this side.
In previous matches, we've seen the United States take a little time to get rolling offensively, and I think that a key thing in this match that they're going to have to do is score on the opportunities that they do create early on in this game.
Coach Heinrichs was genuinely thrilled the excitement level of her players after they beat Costa Rica and qualified for China 2003. I think that surprised her. The U.S., accustomed to so much success, the defending World Cup champions, are indeed very happy to be here. Hooper takes the ball off of Joy Fawcett. Played back in by Sinclair. Kara Lang pressuring. Bounty to the other side. Kat Rennick. Great ball to Tiffany Milbridge. Tiffany Milbridge just won. Well, Tiffany Milbridge, 6 goals in the tournament. Of course, we saw her go for 5 against the Panamanians, and that was a good shot right there.
She's so fast, and I love to see her run and use her speed, and I think that's smart by the United States to play a through ball there over the Canadian defense and let her use her speed and her advantage.
Well, one of the surprises, I think, for the U.S. women, there's not a whole lot with such an established team of players, but Kat Reddick has been solid throughout. She was the one who played that great long ball over the top. Maybe the one question mark April Heinrichs had in, but I think she's answered those questions with sterling performances.
She has been really solid in the back, and she's been one of the only players to play every game of the tournament.
Every minute.
I think she's doing a great job. She's a young player, and she's got a lot to prove, but I think she's done well in the situations that she has been in.
Still playing at the University of North Carolina for Anson Dorrance. Bella Rood, as I mentioned earlier, beat the U.S. before with Norway. In fact, Norway and Canada have faced the U.S. more than any other country. Known it, she's been very solid. Plays for the Atlanta Beat with Charmaine Hooper.
And with Cindy Parlow,
yep.
So I'm sure she knows most of her moves.
Brittany Timko hits the back of Chastain. Hooper trying to grab Chastain. Parlow pokes it forward for Milbritt. Turned away by Nonin. King Sabreau. Stand out at the University of Notre Dame. Helped them win a national championship. Been a solid performer for the U.S. women since 99. Went to Detroit Country Day High School. With a certain basketball player named Chris Webber. Some say Sabreau was the better of the two athletes. High praise, nonetheless. Foul favoring the U.S. Allie Wagner scored the first goal for the U.S. in the tournament. U.S. beat Mexico 2-0 to open their Gold Cup. Back clearance. LeBlanc. She covers it up. I don't know if she kept it in.
It's hard to tell from this angle, but I don't think she did.
Yeah, it looked like the ball had gotten out of play. These two teams have just stormed through the competition. Each have won all four of their matches so far. And have racked up a collective 47 goals and have only allowed one.
Wow.
We expected to see the U.S. and Canada, and that's what we've gotten. We certainly hope for an entertaining match, and it's starting out very much a tight affair. Third meeting between these countries for the CONCACAF crown, with the U.S. winning the previous two. The last meeting in the CONCACAF championships, coming back a couple years ago in 2000, U.S. won 4-1 in Louisville, Kentucky. Shannon Mack scored twice. Mia Hamm and Tiffany Milbritt had the other goals. Fouty. Delightful ball, Tiffany Milbritt. Excuse me, Tiffany Roberts. Right first name. Unable to keep it. Roberts' versatility. She can play in the back, can play in the midfield, can play wide in the midfield, can play central in the midfield, can play defensive midfield, attacking midfield. She's one of those key players for April Heinrichs. And I think for Tiffany, she'll take it. Getting back to the national team picture. As long as her name's on the first team sheet, she won't say much. A flick from Milbritt looking her way. It'll be interesting to see how the Canadian defense responds. This is by far their toughest match. Haven't had anyone that could even threaten the goal, even in an occasional opportunity. Reddick. Good clearance. And this Chapman. He's at the University of Notre Dame. Knocked away from Kara Lang. Behind his head, nothing but high praise for Kara Lang. And Sinclair. Bounced in. Scurry able to cover up. Jonas Scurry yet to allow a goal in the tournament. Two along with Lakeisha Bean. By Fawcett from the San Diego Spirit in the WSA, looking forward to Allie Wagner. Wagner standout and the defending NCAA champions, Santa Clara Broncos. These several players in this tournament returning to their college teams just in time for the playoffs right around the corner. Certainly the teams have missed their star players, but what a huge boost to get players who've been playing at this high level back for the playoffs.
Perfect timing.
Yeah, perfect timing. There's Caroline. A bad ball. Fawcett clears it away. Hooper being cloaked by a pair of defenders. Knocks it back first time. The ball will have just enough legs to get over the end line for a goal kick.
Both of those these teams' defenses haven't been tested throughout the whole tournament, so I think that it's going to be the defense that stays composed and stays more organized that's going to get the win here. And I think that the United States maybe have an advantage over the Canadian defense because of the fact that they're used to playing teams that don't really threaten them or pose much threat to them. And coming into a big game like this, they're ready, and I'm not sure if the Canadian team is used to blowing teams out every game and then having to step up the intensity level and play a team like the United States.
Well, one thing's for sure, they've weathered the early storm, as has the Rose Bowl. The rain is let up for the time being. Good news for the quality of play. Wagner takes it away from Timko. Wagner doesn't hit enough of it. Hooper, good win. Such a physical player. Using her body again to hold it. Surrounded by red jerseys. He gives it up. Now, Silvana Bertini. Cooper goes down. Wagner inside the center circle. Wants to play it long and does to Milbert. Milbert has a step. Milbert the chip! Into the hands of LeBlanc. And twice they've found Tiffany Milbert, and twice she's had good looks at goal.
Well, that's working for them. Tiffany Milbert that time saw a little open space over the head of LeBlanc, tried to chip it over but didn't get enough on it.
Wagner doing the same, but easily handled by LeBlanc. She plays for the Boston Breakers and WSA as well.
I think it's good to test LeBlanc early. We've seen her in a couple games kind of making some risky plays. Even though she hasn't really been tested, she's come off her line a few times when she didn't need to, so I think it's smart to test her out early.
Zabrell gets it away as the puddles twice claim passes. Fawcett. Sinclair. Well away from the goal, which suits the U.S. just fine. Zabrell heads it away. Milbert got a foot in there. Timko back. Timko on the ground. Good first time ball. Fowdy looking to play long. Blocked by Timko. Handball. Timko, the youngster, just 17. He's the hard-working player in the midfield for Evan Pellerud. Kat Reddick. Chastain didn't hit it well. Turned back her direction. Good clearance, in fact. All the way back in the U.S. half. Wagner, Outside the right foot ball. Chested down by Cindy Parlow. Parlow trying to get it through the legs of Tinko. She slides to win it. Reddick. Bertini there. Sinclair giving chase. Sinclair was on the losing end of that under 19 Women's World Cup, the first Women's World Cup of that kind. Sold out crowd in Canada, saw the home team lose to the U.S., and that has really sparked this rivalry. The U.S. played their first ever international against Canada back on July of 1986. And 2 days later, they lost to Canada for the first time. Canada have only beaten them twice since. Chapman trying to get to the in line. Picking off the ball by Christine Lilly. Quarter an hour gone here at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. No score between U.S. and Canada. Two teams expected to be in this final. Fowdy touches it forward. Good touch by Wagner. Creative stuff in the rain. Good side for Sobrero on the ground forward. Errant touch from Randy Hermes. No throw in for the U.S. Milbrick. As the rain has returned. Roberts. Hooper. Can't control it. Sobrero. Parlow trying to leave it for Milbert. Milbert wins it. Good hold. Milbert. Wrecking traffic. Trying to play it through. Never had a chance. Milbert. First time ball. Fowdy. With the head of Milbert looking for Parlow. Fawcett. U.S. keeping everything very simple in the back.
I think on that last chance for the United States, it took a little too long to switch from right to left and to develop Tiffany Milbrick kind of telling the far side player, I think it was Lilly, to make that run. And she could have just played it to Wagner, and Wagner could have maybe saw somebody else that played it to her.
Fowdy able to regain her footing and draws a foul in the process. Andrea Neal, the guilty party. U.S. beginning with Mia Hamm, Shannon McMillan, Heather O'Reilly, Angela Hughley, Lori Fair, and Jenny Benson, along with backup keeper Lakeisha Bean on the bench. The volley is wide. For Canada, Melanie Booth, Sasha Andrews, Claire Rustad, Amy Walsh, Carmelina Moscato, Erin McLeod, and Christina Kiss, who's had a pretty decent tournament, on the bench for Evan Pellerup. Charmaine Hooper scored 3 goals in the 2 Canadian victories over the U.S. since 1986. Certainly a big advantage for Canada to have Hooper. Oh, poor clearance. Hooper's on it. Trying to set it up for Timko, but there's Fowdy. Kara Lang took too much of the ball to Allie Wagner. Wagner gets it forward. Only as far as Chapman. Chapman, the cross. Brianna Scurry wandering off her line. Chastain has it. Playing with either foot. Her footer gets it to Milbert. Milbert winning it. It's tough from Canada right now. Bertini, first time ball in. Fawcett. Everyone talking to her. She knew that she could control it. Fowdy, toe pokes to Wagner. Good ball by Fowdy. Wagner, left-footed ball into the space for Parlow. LeBlanc, good read. We talked about how adventurous she is that time. She needed to be.
Yeah, that was a smart play there to come off her line with Parlow breaking through.
Kate Sobrero. This ball won by Hermes. And Andrea Neal. Tackled by Roberts as she got caught on the ball momentarily. Strong tackle right there, and then Roberts committing the foul, pulling down Neal. Stephanie Roberts, a very feisty player. Likes to mix it up.
She plays a lot bigger than she is.
Credit to her tenacity and her determination. Known it. And Scurry off her line. Makes easy work of it. We talked about it momentarily early on in the tournament, but Brianna Scurry's done a good job. I think maybe in 2000, after what she did in 99 with the U.S. women, rested on her laurels a bit. Maybe lost a little focus. Easy to do, certainly, after winning the World Cup. Lost her spot, and looks like she's finally got herself in tip-top physical shape. And she's fighting once again for that number one spot.
Yeah, she definitely looks good and stronger and more fit than she ever has. And I think it is that focus and determination. She wants her spot back. And I know it's going to be tough for her to maybe secure that spot with the number of goalkeepers that are at that level, but she looks good and she's doing what she can to get in there, and right now she has it.
At least we forget Brianna Scurry made the huge save in the penalty kick shootout with China.
No one can forget that.
Yeah, well, Brandi Chastain kind of stole the thunder. But again, credit everyone that day, especially the shootout takers. The United States made all five of their shootout attempts. Roberts. What kind of play by Sinclair? Sobrero. Wants to play it long. She does, on her left foot. Not a bad ball over the shoulder of Milbritt. Straight to an awaiting LeBlanc. Brianna LeBlanc, 22 years of age, 21 caps when the tournament began. Poked away from Sinclair. Sobrero. The ball's been on this near side. Deflected on the way through. There's LeBlanc, acting like a sweeper that time. Makes the play again because Parlow had to step over any defender in the vicinity. Timko, good tackle. Hooper opens herself up to Sinclair. Sinclair back to Timko. She doesn't take a touch on it, and she lost it. Got to take a touch in the midfield. But the U.S. can't do anything with it. Good ball behind Kat Reddick. Kara Lang pumping those arms, and Reddick slide tackles it out of play for a corner kick. First of the match for the Canadians. Scurry quickly on the spotlight. Scurry, 31 years of age. Curry, one of 10 players with over 100 caps on this Gold Cup roster.
Martini's got to do a little better with that corner. She's the captain, one of the older players on Canada, and she's got to set the tone for this Canadian team.
In these tight matches, how big are set pieces and corner kicks? and the team giving an inch defensively. It will continue to loom large. Halfway through the first half of the 2002 Women's Gold Cup Final. Our referee, Diane Fredetta James, keeping everything in order. And Claire with the bear hug on Roberts. Just wanted to let her know that she really likes her as a player and appreciate what she's done for women's soccer.
I'm sure that's exactly what she said.
Sinclair, a tremendous talent at the University of Portland. Under a long line of talented Portland Pilot players under Clive Charles. Two of them for the U.S., Tiffany Milbert and Shannon McMillan, who starts this match on the bench. I also want to say again, Clive Charles, get well. I wish you all the best in your recovery. Fighting against cancer. Our thoughts and prayers are with you. Bowdy. Reddick sweeps it forward, first time out of the reach of Lilly. Not much going on down the left for the U.S. Everything's really been centrally played. Timko. Timko again. Scurry wants a touch, but she'll back off for Sobrero. Wagner. Chapman sitting deep into the space. Sobrero, the ball finding her quite a bit in this match so far. Always fun when you're outside back and the ball seems to be attracted to you. Lilly, most capped player ever. Good ball, Milbert! Oh, what a goal! Tiffany Milbert scores her seventh goal of the tournament, and the U.S. score first.
What a goal by Tiffany Milbert. We usually see her running on ball onto the ball with a breakaway from her and the keeper. This time she comes through with the volley, puts it in the back of the net. What a shot.
I tell you what, she nearly put a hole in the back of the net. What a first-time volley. She got inside her mark. And just a tremendous finish.
LeBlanc had no chance. She has to be happy with that one.
I tell you what, she didn't celebrate much when she scored five times against Panama. Time for the most ever for a U.S. women player in a game. But that was world class, and even she knows those are hard to reproduce. Milbert getting her 95th goal for the U.S. as she's working her way toward the 100th mark. Milbert only trails Mia Hamm, 135. Elisabetta Binotto of Italy, 107. Carolina Morris, 105. And Michelle Ankers, 104. All time. Select company. Fog has settled in to the Arroyo Grande. Both ball courts in a canyon. Lilly. As we said, there wasn't much going on the far side, and that's where the goal comes from. Lifted forward. Roberts. She was onside. Canada stopped playing. And Roberts, maybe running from a deep lying position in the midfield, able to win it.
Is that, as a coach, just kills you. You never want to see your players stop play, play for the call.
Wagner trying to pick out the goal scorer, Milbritt. Alana Bertini able to press forward, but not in this match. April Heinrichs actually has scored against Canada in a CONCACAF qualifying tournament. Heinrichs scoring a 5-0 victory over Haiti back in 1991. Heinrichs, of course, trying to be the first woman ever to win a World Cup as a player and win a World Cup as a coach. Past the half-hour mark, the fog has settled in at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena to go along with some rain. The United States have a one-goal lead. Tiffany Milbritt with a tremendous goal, one of the best of the tournament. Of a beautiful cross from Christine Lilly. Lilly working on Chapman. She knocks it out of play. Only the second goal the Canadians have conceded. That one skied over the target. And now the Canadians have to be thinking, what's happened to our offense? Non-existent in the semifinal victory over Mexico, as we've said throughout the day. Two own goals, giving Canada a two-goal win that day. Here they are, struggling again to generate much attack outside of Charmaine Hooper. And right now, the U.S., in support of their one-goal lead, have controlled the play. Pinballs around to Fowdy. Sobrero keeps LeBlanc at home. And Janiel. Hooper. Somehow find Bertini. Bertini. And hold by Sinclair, playing with her back to goal. And Sobrero able to cut it out. Roberts. Good turn by Milbritt. Taken off the ball by Randy Hermits.
I think if Canada can do a better job of when they do win the ball and turn it into offense, I think if they can play the ball forward a little quicker and not allow the United States, which has such good team defense, to retreat back and get back in front of the ball, they'll do a better job and have a better create a little bit more opportunities.
Good point, Tracy. And the U.S. with the restart. Conditions much better in this match than in the third place match won by Mexico. Wagner kept it on goal, but why? There's the only goal scorer of the match, Tiffany Milbritt. The seventh goal in the championship, tying her with Christine Sinclair of Canada, who hasn't had a shot on goal yet in this one. Sinclair, of course, 10 goals in the under-19 tournament, winning both the Golden Ball and the Golden Boot. The leading goal scorer and the best player of the tournament. And so far, Sinclair has been pegged out wide, and the U.S. defense, Tracy, have done a good job of keeping her from getting a rhythm.
Yeah, it's definitely hard coming in, playing the United States. They know your number, and they know what you like to do and your tendencies, and I think She has to be a little bit more involved and a lot more active than she was in the game against Mexico. Maybe her confidence went down a little bit, playing a little bit of a tougher opponent, but I think she can, maybe when things aren't working on offense, retreat and play back and play defense, because it can get you going that way.
Tim Cohn with the long range shot, hoping for the best. Here's Scurry. Her 110th appearance for the U.S. Played in every match in the tournament except one. Lakeisha Bean getting the start against Panama. Final group match. Kat Reddick, where are you? Good home by Milbritt. Wagner. She really does a good job of connecting the dots from side to side. Good win by Bertini. Taking the ball away from Roberts. Roberts getting back goal side. That pressure from behind, forcing the premature pass from Bertini. Sobrero. Dancing her way into the midfield. Parlow to Wagner. Great ball on the ground, Milbritt. There's LeBlanc. She can't hang on to it. Now it's out of the area. Bertini has it. Her favorite left foot.
Well, LeBlanc did well there again, coming off of her line. And I think that's an advantage she has playing against players like Milbritt. When you see her in the lineup, you know what she's going to do. And you know that she likes the through ball. So she's going to be ready to have to come out a lot this game.
She has done it quite a bit, venturing toward the edges of her area. LeBlanc. Oh, went off of Roberts. She couldn't find it. Let's keep it. That one went off of Bertini. U.S. in the midst of an impressive 15-game unbeaten streak at home, dating back to a 3-2 win over Mexico in December of 2000. Of course, that was preceded by the USA's last loss at home, a 3-1 loss to Canada back in November of 2000. Nearly 2 years to the day. Last meeting between the two clubs, 1-0 to the U.S. back in July of 2001. The goal scorer that day in Blaine, Minnesota, Tiffany Milbritt. She's a goal scorer this evening. Canada trying to string together some possession. Allie Wagner slid a long way. Still almost kept it alive. Ball went in and then out. U.S. throw in. Sinclair with the tackle and Sobrero. Hooper surrounded by a trio of red jerseys. Roberts, Foudy. Kimco pressuring. Fawcett gets it away. And the U.S. women playing very safe in the back. Wagner, good hold on Nonet. Trying to play it through. The run wasn't there. LeBlanc. The fog as thick as it's been. Reddick. Lily can't hang on to it. Now, where's the Santa Ana winds when you need them? Come in and blow out this fog. Wagner. Julie Foudy. Switch, and Sobrero, despite her good effort, can't hang on to it. Hooper. Not a bad ball in behind the U.S. defense. The cross deflected out of play for a corner. And actually goes the other way for a goal. Kara Lang with a good run.
It's good to see Kara Lang involved a lot in the game already. I think that she creates a lot for Canada, and she's what, you know, starts their attack a lot of times, so it's good to see her involved in this game. I don't think she was involved as much as she should have been in Mexico, so I think that's a plus for Canada.
Well, she's certainly more involved than Sinclair, who's been really pinned in on the near sideline. There's Lang now on the ball, pokes it forward into space for Hooper. Puddle holds it up, ball square. Sinclair, and she's going to get a whistle and a free kick in a good spot for Canada. Well, Sinclair finally got forward and right on cue, able to get a foul. 5 minutes to go in the first half.
It's a great chance for Canada, just outside the 18, and we've seen them a couple of times have some close free kicks, and Kara Lang put one in for Canada, so we'll see what they do here.
They seem to do better on the long-range free kicks. This one's going to take a little finesse. Sinclair standing over at Lang as well. The U.S. wall on its toes. The free kick straight into the wall. Lang with the cutback. Sent to all fours. Fawcett, well, it seems to be the right place at the right time. Parla, pass Temko, cross midfield, gets it back inside the center circle looking for help. Finds it in Foudy. Far side, Reddick. Touched it forward, short for Lilly. Hooper taking off the ball, but Fawcett helps out. Fawcett has it on her foot, Foudy. Wagner. Oh, good look. Parlo. The shot in, and that's well held. A fantastic ball through the U.S. Changing its style on the fly in this tournament. Much more direct. Living and dying by the through ball, and so far, it's done enough to unlock this Canadian defense.
I think Allie Wagner is another one of those players that has done so well when she's had the chance and has come in and proven herself in this tournament.
She really has, and I think this is the first time she's really been given the keys to the team in terms of wearing the number 10 and running the show. She's done a good job in this match, spraying the ball all over the field as Milbert brings down Andrea Neal. Karina LeBlanc. The U.S. defense still have not allowed a goal in the tournament. Crowd the Rose Bowl trying to get into it before halftime. Parlo. She gets the foul, she does. Sinclair disagrees. Back to live action. Milner trying to get to the end of another ball through. LeBlanc has it inside the final 2 minutes. Hooper. Out of her reach, but there's Sinclair. Now she's beginning to get herself involved. Hooper! And the flag is up offside. Very close. See Hooper standing there, hands on her hip, flat-footed, and the ball came in. An offside position.
Yeah, she kind of got caught there standing a little bit. But she wasn't off by much.
She wasn't, just enough. That's all it takes. Sobrell. In the U.S. defense, staying away from the big mistakes. Keeping everything nice and tight in the back. No one trying to do too much on the ball. In the rain. The final half minute before stoppage time. Parlo to Milbritt. Milbritt wins it. Takes a forearm shiver from Nonan. Look at the white jersey that surrounded Milbritt. Headed away by Andrea Neal. Wagner can't win it. Bounces to Lang. Lang through the legs of Lilly. Good hold by Hooper. Fawcett takes her off the ball. Hooper and Fawcett get tangled up. We're into stoppage time. 1 minute has been added on. Marnetta Lang from the Bahamas, our fourth official. Working inside that minute now. U.S. getting their 23rd goal of the tournament. Tiffany Milbritt has scored 7 of them. Nearly a third of the scoring load coming from the number 16. And a great goal in a tight match separates the two clubs. And we're just seconds away from halftime. This time the Canadians earn a corner kick. Need to hurry here. They're going to get it in. Bertini hustling up. The fog not that bad at field level. This should bring it in to half. Number one, Canada trying to tie the match. Kept alive. And it's in. They get a huge goal. Through guess who? Charmaine Hooper. The first goal the U.S. has allowed comes with the final kick of the first half in the Gold Cup final.
Charmaine Hooper does what she can to get on this ball, and she's the one player that the United States had a little fear in them for, and she does well here and ties it up just before the half.
A huge swing in momentum. The Canadians outplayed. Get a goal for their big gun. The 10th goal, the number 10 for Canada. Charmaine Hooper has scored against the U.S. The most for any player against the U.S. all time. We're tied at a goal apiece. We'll be back with halftime after the break. You're watching Fox Sports World.
My son Donovan and I are making sure everyone in Philly is eating good. You need some nice, hot, chunky soup to fill you up right.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger. Big chunks of veggies and hearty sirloin burgers grilled to perfection.
How can I thank you guys?
Mom, one more.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger fills you up right.
Discussing a man's sexual behavior is always a very discreet topic. This commercial talks about NRX, a safe, natural alternative to prescription drugs when you want that extra burst of sexual energy.
Are you one of the millions of American males who would like increased sexual energy when you need it most? NRX is the answer.
It can give you the strength and the stamina that you've never had before.
Yeah, stamina is probably a good way to put it.
Clinical studies show various ingredients of NRX to enhance sexual energy and performance when taken on a regular basis.
You'll feel like you were back in high school when girls were the only thing on your mind.
You'll love all the attention you'll get from your husband. Could save your marriage.
NRX is the perfect, all-natural herbal supplement. With NRX, you'll feel the increased energy within minutes. You'll enjoy your newfound energy the natural way, without chemicals. Order NRX today, and it will be delivered discreetly to your home. We're so sure you and your mate will be completely satisfied, we'll offer you a 30-day, no-questions-asked, full refund.
NRX stimulates sexual energy by expanding the blood vessels, causing increased blood flow to specific areas of the body.
Before, it was like once or twice a month with no energy, no stamina. But now, it's like about every single day.
It's great.
Remember, if you're not happy for any reason, just return the empty bottle within 30 days. We'll give you all your money back.
Call 1-800-365-9392 and order InterX now. Forget those expensive pills and chemicals. Get results using the safe, effective, all-natural alternative, InterX. Call in the next 10 minutes and find out how you can get 1 month of InterX free. Take advantage of this special TV offer. Do it for yourself and for the one you love. Call 1-800-365-9392. That's 1-800-365-9392.
It's live soccer action from the cradle of future champions. The 19th Central American and Caribbean Games on closed circuit TV. See Mexico, El Salvador, Honduras, Colombia, Guatemala, Jamaica, Haiti, and more. Go for the gold on closed circuit TV, November 23rd through December 7th, live from El Salvador. Order now.
La Liga. Spain's internationally renowned soccer league comes to you exclusively on Fox Sports World. La Liga features a collection of elite soccer greats such as Zidane, Ronaldo, Riquelme, Roberto Carlos, Figo, and Raul. Real Madrid and FC Barcelona are only two of the many great teams that play here on Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
It's raining, the fog has set in, but we still have a very good 2002 Women's Gold Cup final here at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. The U.S. scored first, but Charmaine Hooper getting a huge goal. The stroke of halftime to tie us at a goal apiece, the 10th goal Charmaine Hooper scored against the U.S. women. We'll be back with highlights and stats from the first half. Don't go anywhere.
That's M-Life from AT&T Wireless. Plans to keep you connected start at $19.99 a month.
Discussing a man's sexual behavior is always a very discreet topic. This commercial talks about NRX, a safe, natural alternative to prescription drugs when you want that extra burst of sexual energy.
Are you one of the millions of American males who would like increased sexual energy when you need it most? NRX is the answer.
It can give you the strength and the stamina that you've never had before.
Yeah, stamina is probably a good way to put it.
Clinical studies show various ingredients of NRX to enhance sexual energy and performance when taken on a regular basis.
You'll feel like you were back in high school when girls were the only thing on your mind.
You'll love all the attention you'll get from your husband. Could save your marriage.
NRX is the perfect, all-natural herbal supplement. With NRX, you'll feel the increased energy within minutes. You'll enjoy your newfound energy the natural way, without chemicals. Order NRX today, and it will be delivered discreetly to your home. We're so sure you and your mate will be completely satisfied, we'll offer you a 30-day, no-questions-asked, full refund.
NRX stimulates sexual energy by expanding the blood vessels, causing increased blood flow to specific areas of the body.
Before, it was like once or twice a month with no energy, no stamina. But now, it's like about every single day.
It's great.
Remember, if you're not happy for any reason, just return the empty bottle within 30 days. We'll give you all your money back.
Call 1-800-365-9392 and order InterX now. Forget those expensive pills and chemicals. Get results using the safe, effective, all-natural alternative, InterX. Call in the next 10 minutes and find out how you can get 1 month of InterX free. Take advantage of this special TV offer. Do it for yourself and for the one you love. Call 1-800-365-9392. That's 1-800-365-9392.
Place.
La Boca neighborhood, Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Stadium.
La Bombonera.
Capacity.
60,245.
Home of.
Club Atlético Boca Juniors.
Historical matches.
Argentinian National Championships. Copa Libertadores Finals in the 1978 World Cup. The place where Maradona, Batistuta, and Riquelme became stars.
The greatest stadiums in the world, brought to you as only Fox Sports World knows how.
Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
FX Originals. Exceptional movies.
I did what I had to do.
Exhilarating series. Extraordinary television. Premiering December, based on the explosive true story, The Pentagon Papers. In January, meet the new Emmy-nominated top drama, The and this spring, John Corbett stars in the new FX comedy series, Lucky. Due to the original, you won't see anywhere else. FX Original.
The U.S. and Canada lock into a good one here in the 2002 Women's Gold Cup Final. A goal apiece after 45 minutes of action from the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. First half highlights. Tiffany Milbert got off to a good start. Whipped in a good shot right there, just wide. LeBlanc in the Canadian goal. More from the U.S. Allie Wagner. Again, Milbert. Little chip. Can't get enough air underneath it. LeBlanc was certainly off her line. Minute 27. Finally, Milbert. A roof job. Nearly tore a hole in the back of the net. Fantastic goal. Her tournament co-leading, seventh. And that gives the U.S. the one-goal lead. But then in the fog, just before halftime, the U.S. unable to clear the danger. Charmaine Hooper makes them pay. Big goal for the Canadians. Outplayed in the first half. Let off the hook. The first goal the U.S. has allowed in the tournament. And the Canadian fans enjoying the lead. 1-1 the score at halftime. We look at the stats, Tracy, and the U.S. 8 shots, the Canadians just 2.
Yeah, they got to do a better job of finding Hooper and Sinclair. Sinclair, like we said, needs to be a little bit more active.
Once Sinclair got involved, that seemed to take some of the pressure off Hooper. And what do you know? She's able to score again against the U.S. women. When we come back, we'll have the second half kickoff. Who will win the 2002 Gold Cup Final? Stay with us and find out.
Skip, that is a great idea. I'm gonna get some creamer.
Can't get in.
Hey, Tom. Did you get in?
Huh?
When text messaging works for you.
I did.
Good.
That's M-Life from AT&T Wireless. Your mobile life made better.
My son Donovan and I are making sure everyone in Philly is eating good.
Oh, man, hey, what are you doing?
You need some nice, hot, chunky soup to fill you up right.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger. Big chunks of veggies and hearty sirloin burgers grilled to perfection.
How can I thank you guys?
Donovan! Oh, Mom, one more?
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger fills you up right.
I've always loved working on computers, and in the Army, that's what I do. I set up networks, I troubleshoot, I basically do things I would have never dreamed I'd been able to do before.
If you never thought about the U.S. Army or Army Reserve, think about this. There are 212 ways for you to become a soldier and work at a job you'll love. Call for this free video to find out which job is right for you.
I'd never really thought of the Army as a choice.
Your free video will also give you an idea of what Army life is like, how you can earn money for college, even what questions to ask your recruiter.
I'm going to walk away with a lot of memories, a lot of friends, and something that's going to change me for the rest of my life.
Call 1-800-645-ARMY right now, and you'll also receive a free Army t-shirt. Discover the 212 ways you can be an Army of One.
If you would ask me a year ago if I'd be here doing this, I could have never imagined it. I love what I do. I love doing it for the Army.
Hi, I'm Prince Albert of Monaco, and as a 5-time Olympian, I'm proud and pleased to tell you about the upcoming Central American and Caribbean Games in El Salvador. This is the 19th time these games are held. In fact, since 1926, they've been held continuously every 4 years. Beginning on November 23rd through December 7th, 5,000 athletes from 32 different countries will compete in 37 different sports in El Salvador.
A way of expressing, a way of interpreting, a way of life. The Scottish Premier League is on display as 12 teams render their souls while defending their pride to become the new king in the league that defines champion spirit. The Scottish Premier League on Fox Sports World, your home of world-class soccer.
The 16th and final match of the 2002 Women's Gold Cup here at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena, the site of the 1984 Olympic final, the site of the 1994 World Cup final, the 1999 Women's World Cup final, and today the 2002 Women's Gold Cup final as well. Huge goal for the Canadians at halftime, and that's got April Heinrichs into action. As Lori Fair and Mia Hamm check in to start the second half. The countries will switch ends. Canada with the ball going left to right in the white and red kits. We'll start with the ball in the second half. One won the score. We get set for what should be a very entertaining final 45 minutes of action in the 2002 Women's Gold Cup. Both the teams have already qualified for China 2003, but would love to end their tournament with a championship. The crowd has slowly but surely made its way in, despite the rain and the fog. So Tracy, what do you make of the substitutions? Hamm and Fair in.
Well, I think like in previous matches, April Heinrichs is just trying to get something going. The right combination of players in, because they need more goals. They've created good opportunities, maybe not the most that they could have were expected to in the first half, but I think she's doing it to mix things up and get more goals.
Tiffany Roberts came off for Lori Fair. We're just awaiting the second half kickoff. Our referee, Diane Fredette-James for Guyana. Finally, gets half number two underway. And the U.S. finally cracked for a goal. Mia Hamm is in and she goes down. Trying to get a free kick. Christine Lilly helped set up the first goal. Knocked out of play again by Brianna Boyd for a throw-in.
If you're trying to turn things on for the American offense, you can bring in number nine, Mia Hamm. She's going to be the best option for the United States to produce more goals and go up by more than a goal in this game.
Here's Fair. Her first look at possession. Back to Sobrero. Sala on the ball in the first half. That's a good hold by LeBlanc. One of her better plays of the match. U.S. unbeaten her last 15 matches at home since losing to the Canadians. Wagner slips it through to Hamm. Hamm on that dangerous right foot trying to curl in. LeBlanc wasn't so sure. She had a long way to go. In the end, it's wide. Hamm making her presence felt right away. We saw Mia Hamm pick up an injury against Panama and been rested, although she's certainly back to full fitness. In some ways, this could be the new role for Mia Hamm for the next couple years. So I think she begins to acknowledge the waning moments of her international career. Great ball on the ground. Hamm, good strike, cleared away. She can talk of retirement later. She very nearly gave the U.S. the lead back. Now the reach of Allie Wagner and the U.S. come out strong in the second half. Foudy wins it. Here's Hamm again. Look at the balance. Gets her head up. Trying to slot it low, and LeBlanc went sliding and got a piece of it. Canada have not generated many opportunities. They got a goal through their old reliable Charmaine Hooper. Bertini. Canada yet to make any substitutions. Andrea Neal goes down. She gets back to her feet. Foudy. Wagner. Trying to bang it through on the ground. Timko. Sinclair does just enough to keep possession. And it ends up on the foot of Sobrero. Sobrero mishit it. Still had eyes to get through. Wagner. Foudy. Kat Reddick. Parlow. U.S. playing with a little bit more urgency after that equalizer from the Canadians. Here's Hooper. She's got that left arm up on Fawcett. Fawcett grabbing Hooper. Those two playing through it. The shot deflected. Reddick off her chest. Scurry can pick it up if she wants. Keeps it at her feet. On the first match, we saw Kerry Seitz a bit sensitive, calling a lot of the touch fouls as Mexico were able to beat Costa Rica 4-1. Take third place. Miss James, our referee, a little bit different there. You saw Fawcett and Hooper tugging at it. Good play by two veteran players. Great hold. Parlow, the keeper, out. Randy Hermans getting back. Touches it out of play for a corner. Randy Hermans, good defending here.
Yeah, she did really well to get back there, and I think she prevented a goal.
Cindy Parlow took a long time to decide to have a go. Five minutes into the second half, the U.S. have a corner kick. Fawcett trying to disrupt LeBlanc. Chastain making the near post. Head away by Sinclair. We'll stay here and do it again. Everyone trying to get loose from their marks. Chastain won it. And keep it on goal. Chastain does have one goal in this tournament. That was the second goal in the 3-0 victory over TNT. Back on October 29th. Fawcett wins it. It's beyond the reach of Wagner. Hooper, good touch. Trying to find Timko. An easy obstruction call. Really going down. We haven't seen the tempers flare at all between these two countries yet. Kara Lang. An easy call in the end. Foudy. Fantastic ball. He was going to get out of play. Fair misjudged it. We talked about Mia Hamm coming on, Tracy. What do you make of the substitution, Fair, for Roberts?
I think Lori Fair brings a lot to this United States team and gets wide and does well with her crosses. I think that April Heinrichs may have put her in there to get some crosses off, and she left Carlo in there, so that's going to be a primary target for Fair to look for in there in the mix.
Bit strange. April Heinrichs rolling the dice, taking out your goal scorer in Tiffany Milbritt.
Yeah, I don't know about that
yeah,
either.
Yeah, in a final.
She's certainly been on fire, and you don't want to certainly stop that.
We'll see if that's a decision that she comes back to lament. Right now, these teams deadlocked at one. Here's Parla. With the soggy stuff on the near side. Pokes it into the air for Wagner. She just opens herself up and just plays, passes. Makes it look easy. It's a good run. Sobrero, though, I think should get the foul and does.
Kind of a late whistle there.
It was. One Sobrero here, held up by Sinclair, and then Bertini, the roadblock. Getting the crowd on their feet. Bangs it low. Good idea. Kept it low and in the traffic. Just cleared away by Canada. Going back to Sobrero, the last player. Reddick. Can't able to get out. That one played back in. Hermes with the header. Met by Niels. Well, I would have expected Canada, Tracy, to come out a little bit more fire in the second half after getting that huge equalizer, but maybe halftime coming at the wrong time for the Canadians, as I think that break allowed the U.S. to gather themselves once again and reestablish their dominance in the match.
I think you're exactly right, and that's what's showing here right now. Canada should be fired up. They scored a goal, and they could have been saying to themselves, well, we haven't played our best, and we have a goal, it's tied, so we can still do this in the second half, but the United States has come out even stronger, and they're controlling most of the tempo here in the second half.
And really, it took a poor clearance by the U.S. to get Canada on the board. Timko. That's not going to get it done. It'll be a goal kick. Timko Parr, the under 19 national team for Canada. Canada is actually hoping to host the 2007 World Cup. And I think what they did in the under 19 inaugural World Cup for women will go a long way into helping them solidify the bid. Also, a strong performance in China won't hurt. That's actually Evan Pellerud's charge since he took over after leading Norway to the 1995 World Cup, was to host the 2007 World Cup and win it. He's gotten Canada headed in the right direction. That lofty goal may become a reality. Chapman getting the spot further upfield. She'll gladly take it. One by Reddick. Wagner to Fowdy. Those two have done a good job of staying close to one another, making it easy for whichever one's on the ball. Chastain, he certainly can press forward. Wagner, good hold on the ground. Ball out wide, first time's a good one. Cross from Lily, she couldn't get her hips around on it. One of the toughest things to do as a flank player, hit that ball across the area when it's rolling away from you.
Especially when your footing isn't as stable as it normally is.
Canada with all 11 players that started the match. Behind Mick sticking to her squad rotation. I'm sure as long as this match stays tied, Mia Hamm already on. Probably means we'll see Shannon Mack before too long. LeBlanc being shouted by Hamm. Lily. Ham. Wagner. Parlow. Trying to hold it. Turned herself into trouble. And taken away. Sobrero brings it down. Again a long ball. Again a good one. Lily. This time she gets her feet right, but that touch let her down. Hooper checking back to get it. And the ball goes well past her. Again, a little possession in this half. Even less than the same point in half number one. Chastain made the transition to center back seamlessly.
And as the United States continues to possess, I think that they can push their outside backs forward and get into the space that's in front of them, because the only player up there for Canada that's pressuring is Charmaine Hooper. And you don't really need four people to mark one, so I think that they can have the freedom to push some of their defenders up.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you. One of the players can go, but the way Hooper's been playing and the way she has really had success against the United States, I think Joy Fawcett and company are quite aware of Hooper and her ability to get goals, so they'll keep up tight reins on her.
Oh yeah, I definitely agree. They know that she's a threat, and that's what Canada wants to do. They want to use the counter and the long ball to get in there and maybe create a chance for themselves.
Chapman is there. Chastain, the neat header. There's three versus one that time. Hooper, well marked. Wagner on the ground for Parlow. Or Ham. It was right in between the both of them. LeBlanc is the one who wins it. Here's Sinclair. Sobrero can't get enough on the clearance. Sinclair trying to hold it. Here comes a double team from Fair. Senses the pressure, plays it all the way back into the midfield for Bertini. Skied it. No problem at all for Brianna Scurry. Bertini gives it away to Wagner. Foudy. Reddick. Back to Foudy. Stayed in the support position. Foudy plays for the San Diego Spirit in the WSA. Chastain, who plays for the San Jose Cyber Rays. Lily. Makes up for that pass from Wagner. Stuff from Allie Wagner. Foudy now. A little bit more forward. Cleared away. Again, Nonan's put out most of the fires in the back. Here's Fair. Pass Bertini. Fair the cross. Blocked by Randy Hermes. Good cover by Hermes. Be a throw in. Past the hour mark, 1-1. United States scored first. Tiffany Milburn in minute 27. Charmaine Hooper, the last kick of the half. Time to score for the Canadians. Ellen Hopkins alongside Tracy Milburn, the 16th and final match, the 2002 Women's Gold Cup. Neil has it, and I have to say, Tracy, it's been a lot of fun having you here. So glad to have you with us.
And I thank you, Max, for putting up with me. I know it's hard to have a rookie, and it's been great, though. It's been fun.
Well, you're a rookie with zero caps, but you've been here for all 16 matches, so that's changed. You've done fine work, and like I said, we've all enjoyed having you here, and you brought a nice bit of knowledge and expertise to the broadcast.
Thank you.
Headed away by Timko. Hooper. Again, the U.S. well organized, good shape defensively. Scurry back out to Sobrero. Mm-hmm. crowd getting excited each and every time the ball heads toward Mia Hamm. And back to Fowney. In some ways, April Heinrichs rolling the dice. I guess you can say, I don't know if anyone's ever said that, bringing on Mia Hamm, but she has yet to get a goal in the tournament. And she certainly isn't going as well as Tiffany Milbritt.
Well, Mia Hamm performs well, very well, actually, in pressure situations. She can come on and change the game for you. And I'm not sure if she should have brought out Tiffany Milbritt. She's been playing very well throughout the whole tournament, and even in this match has had a number of opportunities for the United States. So we'll see if her gamble is a good thing and a smart move.
Hamm! Great hold by LeBlanc. Well, certainly, I'm not questioning what Mia Hamm has done over the years. Tournament tactics, certainly a bit different. She almost ran onto the end of another good pass. But I think you're right. I think the gamble was taking off Milbritt more than taking off Hamm, or bringing on Hamm. Has scored the last five times Canada played the U.S. Getting a goal in this one. Wagner, good hold. Wagner spins. Wagner plays it on the ground. Hamm was trying to stay onside. Ball more direct, and LeBlanc is there. LeBlanc has had quite a bit of work, and she hasn't looked too nervous. Nothing she could do on the Milbritt goal. That was a left-footed laser. Burned a hole in the back of the net. Chastain. Oh, poor ball. She wins it back, however. Hamm. Controls for Fowdy. Lillard. Drawing in Kara Lang. There's Fowdy. Wagner pushing a bit forward. Wagner's on the ball now. Tried to play it through to Parlow first time. Lily. Wagner. There's amazing balance. Sometimes it looks like she's going to give the ball away, and she still has it. Kara Lang. Timko. Bertini. Maury Fair sliding twice. Bertini finally relents and plays it out of play. Christine Lilly. Pat Reddick. Fowdy. On the ground. Andrea Neal. I don't know if Canada completed a pass in the U.S. half during the second half so far. Timko, she's knocking good balls, however, to Chapman. Chapman. Across midfield, flicked on by Kara Lang. Short for Hooper. Chastain, the step over. Nicely done. Fowdy. Out of the reach of Wagner. Fowdy. Gets it right back. And Pellerud, head coach for Canada. Known for his good tactics. And of course, he, along with the U.S., the only countries to win a Women's World Cup. So he's certainly in elite class. Tied at the end of 90 minutes, we will have golden goal and penalties to decide a champion. Chastain. We're heading for the final 20 minutes, Tracy. Here's some of the things maybe Canada can fine-tune. Hang around in this match and maybe sneak out a winner.
Well, I think what they're doing now is a good thing. The score is still 1-1, but I think obviously they need a little bit more offense. And when they get Charmaine Hooper the ball, or when she does win the ball on her defensive efforts, they can help her out. They can give her someone to pass to and give her support.
Brianna Boyd with the clearance as Mia Hamm sent in a quality early ball. And LeBlanc all smiles. U.S. have had possession, but they haven't created as many chances as you might think, considering the dominance. We don't have a possession stat, but you know it's 75-25 in that range. The U.S. have kept the ball much better than the Canadians. The corner coming in, headed down by Foudy. Foudy always seems somehow to be on the end of corner kicks. One post or the other. Fawcett has it go behind him. Hooper. She wins it back, takes a foul from Chastain. The crowd here that's endured the rain doesn't like the foul. I think it was justified in being called.
Well, that was a good job right there by Charmaine Hooper to get back and maybe spark her team with a little defense of her own.
And Hooper again drawing the foul on Chastain, who can't believe it. 34-year-old Hooper, I think, embellished a bit. Going down very easily.
Just a little bit. I think it takes a little more than that to bring
Jeremy
down.
I agree. Wagner, Paulo, Foudy, fair in the U.S. wall. Mia Hamm setting the wall. They'll stay up top. He sets it one more time. Now she'll get back goal side, minute 70. Set pieces. One of the keys we talked about beginning of the match. Voted in, Scurry. And the U.S. defense does well that time.
I thought that was a good idea by Nonan there to serve the ball sort of far post and give her taller targets an opportunity on the through ball there.
Fair. Ball coming her way. Wagner. Spot back in the midfield. Chastain continues her ongoing conversation with Miss James, our referee. We're planting a seed for later on. Lily, cut off by Timko. Chapman comes out with it. Only as far as Kat Reddick. Ball on the ground. Lily, a long way to go. She couldn't get there to lift it up over the sliding Boyd. Brianna Boyd's been one of the better defenders for Canada throughout the entire tournament.
She has been. She's been pretty solid. She did well there to beat out Lily to that ball.
Reddick. Oh, great leave, but straight to LeBlanc. I think it took a slight deflection.
And also, I think took a second for Cindy Parlo to read that flick on by Mia.
Wagner. Delightful ball. Hand. First time in. That was Parlo. Sliding into the picture. Good turn by Lily. Wagner wanted to have a go. The time the wet conditions got the better of her, she just couldn't get the right footing. Good first touch by Kara Lang with the outside of the right foot. Trying to play it onside to Hooper. The flag is up, and thankfully for the U.S., Fawcett just stepped up enough to keep Hooper offside.
Yeah, Hooper wasn't off by much there, and if she was on, she had all kinds of space.
She did. Kat Reddick also almost keeping her on. Chapman sliding to get it forward. Jeff State. Bowdy. Clean ball to Lilly. Wagner checks. It goes forward. Minute 74. You're just joining us. 1-1. 2002 Women's Gold Cup Final. Both these teams have already qualified for next year's World Cup in China. Hooper. Over Scurry. Scurry wasn't that far off her line, but she had to turn and make sure.
Yeah, this shot wasn't off by much, and if you're watching Scurry, it looked like it was a lot more further off than
yep.
It was.
She played it off very well. That was good effort by Hooper. No Brendan Hooper, the only goal scorers of the match. Hooper getting a big goal right before halftime. Last kick of the half, in fact. That's kept Canada in it. Wagner. Trying to slice it outside of the right foot. There's LeBlanc. Sure, with plenty of water in her boots. Minute 75. Sabrell has hands in the back of Hooper. Tinko trying to win it. She does, in fact. Kara Lang had it blocked by Fawcett, pressuring the midfield. Parlo getting back goal side. Chapman. Time ball. Angling up with Hooper. And the Canadians keeping it in the other half. Scurry knocks it down with her knees. Slowly but surely working our way toward extra time and golden goal time. The U.S. just hasn't been able to generate many goal scoring opportunities. Same for the Canadians. The U.S. have had more shots. LeBlanc hasn't been troubled that much in this half. Good run by Kara Lang. Working on Lilly now. Good hold by Lang. For another one for the Puddles. Here's the Rose Bowl. Ball by Fowdy. Sobrero, some space, she'll take it. Cross midfield. Sobrero's got to take some more chances and some overlapping runs. As you said a while back in this half, extra defender, the U.S. should do something with it.
And Kate Sobrero does well. That's part of her game,
yep.
To get forward and get those crosses in.
The U.S. haven't had much service from the flanks. One really good ball they got in. They were able to score. Sobrero gets forward. Not a bad ball. It goes over the head of LeBlanc. Miscommunication. Cleared away by Boyd. Who's been omniscient in the back line for the Canadians. The pencil of April Heinrichs looks on. Very nearly an own goal. Canada were gifted two in the semifinals. You're trying to give one back. Bowdy and Chastain, the danger players for the U.S., driven in. Head away by Bertini. Good clearance. Chastain. Offside. It won't count. Fawcett offside.
Well, it was a good finish by Fawcett. She had a lot of opportunities in the game against Costa Rica, but...
Very close.
Yeah, it was close.
I think that was Nonan that kept her from very nearly being onside.
That was close.
Women 78. Finally a change. Carmelina Moscato, who we saw pick up an injury, sheltered for quite a while in the tournament. She now will replace Andrea Neal, who comes off limping. First substitution for Evan Pellerud. Canada not as deep as the U.S. That is why he's been holding off and making his substitutions. Lori Fair and Mia Hamm, the only two changes for April Heinrich so far. Sydney Parlow with an errant touch. Wonder how much longer April Heinrich will hold on to that final substitution. And really the question is, will it be Shannon Mack? He's been very good in the tournament, scoring four times. She scored at three of the previous four matches for the U.S. in the tournament, so she's been consistent.
I'd have to agree there. If you're looking for a goal scorer, looking for someone to come on and score a goal, looking at what you have out there, the best bet would be Shannon McMillan. I think that April Heinrichs will probably bring her in soon enough.
McMillan scored some big goals in her career for the U.S. Reached the 80th minute. Heading full steam ahead for the final 10. We're looking more and more like we're going to get some bonus action the final day of the 2002 Women's Gold Cup. Canada and the U.S. duking it out toe-to-toe for the tournament title and bragging rights in the region. The U.S. took round one, the under-19 Women's World Cup. Canada looking for revenge. Hooper into the space for Sinclair. Scurry is there. There's a danger. Again, how close is that? Flag just coming up, taking away the Fawcett goal. There may need some controversy. Chastain. Bowdy, that's a good ball, tough ball to knock. Reddick. And a long ball over the top, Boyd. Continues to play well, Wagner. Didn't hit it hard enough for Fair. Bertini, shoulder to shoulder with Fair. Bertini can't get the foul or the ball back. Fair will throw it in. Sobrero. Chapman giving chase. Bangs it off the U.S. player for a throw-in. No. Evan Pellerud felt like his Canadian women were hesitant and nervous. Didn't play up the level they set for themselves in this tournament against Mexico. I think he has to be happy with the way they responded emotionally to this match, matching the U.S. intensity. We expected a defensive battle, each team allowing to combine one goal coming into the match. The U.S. has only allowed one in the entire tournament. Ham trying to fashion a late winner. Pulling it toward Parlow. Parlow hanging on to it. Parlow trying to get to the end line. Across, deflected. Dangerous clearance. LeBlanc goes up. She can't hang on to it. No whistle. Play on. And actually looked like a good non-call by Miss James, our referee. So many times, referees hypersensitive to the goalkeeper. And that was a clean and fair challenge. Just knocking on the door there, but Canada don't let them in. By our lonesome up there. I'm going to do most of the work chasing the U.S. backline players. Parlow gives it away. Square ball. Cut out by Bertini. She can't keep possession. Fair again. She'll leave it for Sobrero. Minute 84, Tracy, and it's getting to that point of the match where you start thinking about extra time. Maybe for the U.S., then we'll cut down their opportunities to go forward to try to keep this match the way it is.
Yeah, and I think, I mean, if you're in the United States, you're supposed to win, you're expected to win this game, and I think they're going to do what they can to win this in regulation. They don't want to see this going to overtime.
Boy, another good win. She's really asserted herself the final 15 minutes. Kimco. Chapman is able to get it forward. Fowdy. Pops it for Ham. Ham gets it back. Lovely first time ball. Ham draws a crowd. Lays it off. The takeover. And Chapman wins it. But good pressure from Wagner. Ellie Wagner coming out of nowhere. Like it should have been a U.S. throw-in. Goes to the Canadians. Bounty. Wagner. Good touch back into the open space. Near side, Sobrero. Sobrero should take this space. Plays it on the ground. Parlow trying to win it back without committing a foul. She did so. Looked a little tired the last couple times. She's had a good look. And that one bounces right on the end, and Bruins out of play. Inside the final 5 minutes, the U.S. have a corner kick. Making a near post run. It comes in. LeBlanc got enough of it. Wagner. Ball in. Seifert away. Reddick. Good stuff to Sobrero. Quality ball to Sobrero. Now he comes back in. Parlow! Mia Hamm picked her out. Then Parlow very nearly had the winner. Great ball by Mia Hamm, Tracy.
It was a great ball by Mia. She just picked out Cindy Parlow, like you said. Just misses wide, and LeBlanc didn't even move.
Didn't move a step. That's one of those ones where you're holding your breath.
Wishing it wide.
Yeah. And I tell you what, the fans on the near side of the stadium, same side as the press box at the Rose Bowl, probably thought it was going in. Didn't know until it crashed into the sideboards behind the goal. The U.S. has been pressuring for a late winner. Since we've headed for the turn in the final stretch. Bounty just keeps on running. Reddick. Good ball to Parlow. Headed away by Bertini, who's Not used to playing 90 minutes in this tournament. Bowdy trying to get around Kara Lang. She has her in an arm bar. Kara Lang shrugs off Bowdy, plays it forward. Hooper. Scrappy stub here. Extra time is looming. Fair. On the ground, but straight to Chapman. The ball had very little chance of getting to its destination on the ground. Hooper. Sinclair. Good hold. Back to Hooper. Senses the pressure. Goes one way, turns the other. Plays it through. Looking for Timko. And Hooper doing a good job keeping possession alive for the Canadians. 2 minutes to go. Evan Pellerud's side has done a good job. They went down early, but kept their hands up, hung around, got the one chance they were looking for in the first half, and then kept the U.S. at bay. Give credit to the Canadian defense. And they're trying to play into the near side corner flag. 90 seconds remaining. Man, some tired legs. The Canadian defense. Wagner. They've had to do a lot of defending in this match. Ham. And that's going to skip easily for LeBlanc.
They have had to do a lot of defense in this game, and I think they're doing a great job. They're getting back on defense there. We saw four Canadian defenders back and one American attacker, so they're still in this and they're still fighting.
They're fighting inside the 90th minute. I don't know how much stoppage time. Give Kara Lang a lot of credit. She's really physically met the challenge of the U.S. women in the midfield. She's been mixing it up and using that big frame of hers to hold on to it. Bang forward. Something on it. Scurry is there. And they shuffle over and scoop it up. Chastain. And then shake off the effects of a blow to the face. Into stoppage time, the 2002 Women's Gold Cup Final. Nothing separating these two countries. As Melanie Booth is set to check in. Flat ball headed away. Wagner. Look at Ham. Great hold. Square. Wagner trying to touch it on. Well, I tell you what, if she would have played that through, the U.S. would have been in business.
And I'm sure that's exactly what was on her mind.
Yeah, she was trying to stretch for it. Heinrichs up off the bench. So Kara Lang, the Gold Cup has come to an end. Another breakout tournament for Lang, who was one of the stars for Canada under 19 Women's World Cup. 16-year-old held her own throughout the tournament and in this final. In the second minute now. LeBlanc, what a solid punt. Clear it away. Chapman on the throw in. Timko wins another throw in. Sinclair, judged to have touched it last. to the third man in stoppage time. And she was a foul. Redick on the restart. Last Chance Cafe for the U.S. women. And that is it. 90 minutes and 2 minutes of stoppage time. Not enough. The 2002 Women's Gold Cup final will be decided in extra time. And if not, we'll go to penalties to decide the regional champion. The United States scored first. Tiffany Milbritt got the goal in minute 27. Charmaine Hooper got the equalizer in minute 45. We'll be back with the golden goal extra time after the break. 1-1 at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena.
That's M Life from AT&T Wireless. Plans to keep you connected start at $19.99 a month.
My son Donovan and I are making sure everyone in Philly is eating good.
Oh, man, hey, what are you doing?
Yeah,
you need some nice, hot, chunky soup to fill you up right.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger. Big chunks of veggies and hearty sirloin burgers grilled to perfection.
How can I thank you guys?
Mom, one more.
Campbell's Chunky Sirloin Burger fills you up right.
Fire mission.
What do you got?
I have a suit rep from Alpha Company.
What is it?
Billy Chief PD, ready to be verified. Verified.
Ever wondered what it's really like to be a soldier? Put yourself in the picture with this free video. You'll see over 200 great jobs in the Army and over 180 in the Army Reserve. You'll also see what skills you learn, how you can earn money for college, plus all the other ways you can keep studying while you're in the Army. You'll even get the chance to see what soldiers do in their free time. Call 1-800-984-ARMY right now, and you'll get this free Army t-shirt and free video. Put yourself in the picture and see what it's really like to become an Army of One.
What's your EPL fantasy? Watching Beckham at Old Trafford, Owen at Anfield, and Ri at Highbury. Play the EPL Fantasy Challenge at foxsportsworld.com, and you can be off to England to see them in person. Plus, every week, the top scorer wins an EPL jersey of their choosing. Register your EPL Fantasy Challenge team today at foxsportsworld.com. You are not alone. The passion is explained with little or no words. Soccer, only on Fox Sports World, the home of world-class soccer.
...16 matches and nearly 1,500 minutes of action in 2002 Women's Gold Cup. And the final has been sent into extra time, 1-1. The score after 90 minutes of action, Milbritt for the U.S., Hooper for Canada. The goal scorers on the evening so far. We don't have a winner at the end of our golden goal extra time. The 2002 Women's Gold Cup final will be decided on penalties. We're at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. The rain has subsided for now. And the brave fans who've battled traffic and wet conditions here in the Southland in California enjoying a good match. Ellen Hopkins alongside Tracy Milburn. Tracy, we heard both coaches before we get this extra time underway. Evan Pellerud focusing on tactics, but April Heinrichs being the cheerleader, really motivating her team for this extra time.
And I think that's exactly what she needs to do. I mean, they know that they're the better team, and they might be a little frustrated coming into this overtime, but they can't let that frustration affect them mentally, and they have to be ready and focused and do everything that they were doing before, but just finish their opportunities that they are getting.
April Heinrichs stressing the fundamentals. She felt like they played very well. They had enough variety in their attack. And she certainly conceded the wet conditions had something to do with it. So again, the U.S. and Canada need a little extra time to decide the championship. Been saying it throughout the course of the evening. The U.S. beat Canada under 19 Women's World Cup. A lot of these Canadian women were on that team, carrying a bit of a fire in their belly all tournament long, looking for a redemption shot against the U.S. They've gotten it, and they've gotten a goal, and we're tied as we get set for extra time. Diana Fedetta James from Guyana, our referee. It's the extra time underway for the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. First extra time session we had in the tournament. Was by far the tightest of the 16 matches in the Gold Cup. U.S. going left to right with the ball to start. Sobrero, long way to run.
I think things will start to open up a little bit, and I think especially for the United States, since they are a deeper team and they've made a number of substitutions, the wear and tear of this whole tournament and the whole physical battle that they have to put on for this 90 minutes is going to affect Canada and the United States to a certain point. So I think things will open up a little bit more in this overtime.
Fatigue, certainly a factor, not only in this match, but in the tournament, as you just mentioned. Also, the legs will be a bit heavier after trudging around in these soggy conditions. Wagner looking to spring Ham. And it back Ham's way, but offside. Boyd again made the initial defensive stop. See Ham pass the last defender. The U.S. did have a goal called back. Offside call that was very, very close. Disallowing a Joy Fawcett goal. It would have prevented this extra time session. Good win by Brittany Timko. Each coach has a substitution remaining. Fair, good first time ball. Wagner gets through the pass from Ham. Wagner holds it around the referee to the near side for Lily. She set up the lone goal for the U.S. Parla trying to hang on to it. She does. She gets a free kick in a good spot. Chance for the U.S. It's Carmelina Moscato. Second substitution of the match for Canada. Melanie Booth the other. Ham and Wagner. It'll be Ham trying to win it. Ham hit it well, but hit it hot. Never had a chance. Good header, Ham. The ball into the back of the net. Mia Hamm wins the 2002 Gold Cup for the United States.
going into overtime and gets the golden goal. A beautiful chip over LeBlanc's head. Brings home this Gold Cup championship for the United States.
Her first goal of the tournament comes just inside extra time. And Mia Hamm does it again. And the U.S. women again take care of Canada in extra time. Urging everyone to join her and celebrate it as the U.S. win the Gold Cup in dramatic fashion. So that's the story from the 2002 Women's Gold Cup. The United States beat Canada thanks to Mia Hamm's golden goal. For the entire crew, Tracy Milburn, I've been your host, Alan Hopkins. We thank you so much for watching the U.S. take home the 2002 Gold Cup on Fox Sports World.
Skip, that is a great idea. I'm gonna get some creamer.
Can't get in.
Hey, Tom. Did you get in?
Huh?
When text messaging works for you.
I did.
Good.
That's M-Life from AT.